morning students, welcome to the class. This is physical education period and I am Mr. Ahmed. Today we will discuss chapter number 6, topic Rickley and Jones senior citizen fitness test. First of all, let me give the introduction of this test. The senior citizen fitness test was developed at Fullerton University by Dr. Roberta Rickley and Dr. Jesse Jones in 2001. As such, the test is sometimes known as the Fullerton Functional Fitness Test. First of all, let me tell you regarding the purpose of this test. The main thing, the purpose of this test is to assess or measure the functional fitness of older adults. Now we will discuss about the procedure of the fifth item of the Rickley and Jones test, which is 8-foot up and go test, whose purpose is to measure speed, agility and balance. And the procedure is as, number one, place the chair against a wall for greater stability and mark 8 feet distance in front of the chair and place an orange cone in front of the chair. Now sit in the chair with your hands on your thighs, your feet on the floor. Upon the signal go, rise from the chair and walk as quickly as possible to the marked place, that is the cone, and walk around it outside of the marked area and return to your seat as quickly as possible. You can take a practice test before testing for a score if you wish. The total time taken by you is your score.
The 8-foot up and go test is used to assess agility and dynamic balance. You again need a straight back or folding chair with a seat height of 17 inches placed against the wall. You'll also need a stopwatch, tape measure, and a cone or similar marker. Place the chair against a wall and position the cone or marker 8 feet, about 2.4 meters, from the front edge of the chair. Instruct the participant to sit in the middle of the chair with back straight, feet flat on the floor, and hands on thighs. One foot should be slightly in front of the other. The participants should get up from the chair, walk as quickly as possible around either side of the cone, then sit back down on the chair. Following the demonstration, have the participant practice the test one time before beginning the test trials. Explain that the goal is to complete the test as quickly as possible, but not to move faster than is safe. The tester must start the timer on go whether or not the participant starts to move. The timing stops when the person sits on the chair. The score is the time elapsed from the go signal to the seated position. Record both test scores to the nearest tenth of a second and use the fastest score.
We will discuss about the procedure of the sixth test item, that is 6-minute walk test, which measures the aerobic endurance of the old people or the adults who are more than 60 years of age. First of all, mark a rectangle area of 20 yard by 5 yard with cones placed at regular intervals to indicate distance walked, or simply place two cones at a 30 meter or 50 meter distance from each other. Now, stand at the starting point and on the command go,
Walk as quickly as possible for 6 minutes to cover as much distance as possible. Subjects are able to stop for a rest if they desire, but the time clock will remain running during that time. The total distance covered by you is your score. Thank you.
A technician will carefully explain the test to you and ask if you have any questions. Your blood pressure, heart rate, breathing rate, and blood oxygen levels will be measured before the test. You will have to walk as quickly as you can along a corridor of 30 to 50 meters. At the end of the corridor, you will turn quickly around a pylon without pausing, and then continue walking. You should try to cover as much ground as possible in 6 minutes. However, if you feel short of breath, have chest pain, or feel faint or dizzy, you will be able to rest briefly before starting to walk again. The technician will not speak to you during the test or encourage you. You should not speak to the technician or your friends and family. The technician will only tell you that you have 4 minutes left, then 2 minutes left, then 15 seconds left, and finally, to stop. A scale will rate your degree of breathlessness as well as fatigue level.
Students, let me tell you, there is a test which is called 2 minutes step test. It is conducted if a person is not going to test for 6 minute walk test. Then we can substitute this 2 minute step test for the 6 minute walk test. The procedure for the 2 minute walk test is, first of all, stand near a marketplace. On the command go, do as many as number of full steps in 2 minutes, raising each knee to a point midway between the patella, that is kneecap, and iliac crest, top hip bone. And the total number of full steps you are completing in the 2 minutes is your score. This is all. That is the end of the Rickley Jones test.
Okay, this test is test the aerobic endurance of an older adult. And this is the 2 minute step test. And so we have to measure the distance of which her knee is going to come up on that step. And the way we're going to do that is measure from her iliac crest, which is that most bony part on the hip, and then we'll measure down to the middle of the patella. And on Mary Louise, it's 20 inches. So obviously half of 20 is 10, so I'm gonna put my finger on the 10 inch mark, and I have tape already in place that I can use. I'm gonna place it on her thigh there. Okay, so there's the marker on her thigh. Now I have to place another piece of tape on the wall. The way I'm gonna do that is have Mary Louise turn around, and I have another piece of tape ready. Okay, so come close to the wall, and I'm just going to then place that piece of tape and match it with the one that's on her leg. Okay, now step away from the wall over here. Okay, so here's the height. That's kind of crooked. Let me straighten it out. Okay, so there's the height. But I have found it much easier to take a longer piece of tape okay, at that height, because she's going to travel back and forth just naturally, and that gives me some wiggle room to be able to, as she's doing this step test. So what I'm going to have her do is come close to the wall, okay, and when I say go, she's going to march in place And both knees have to go at the height of the tape or higher. If it doesn't, then I don't count those steps. And I remind her, I tell her to keep going during that 2 minutes, but remind her to get the knees up. But I can't count the ones if they're below the tape. So we'll go ahead and demonstrate that. So on go, you'll march in place and getting both knees at the height of the tape or higher. Okay, and then so obviously I have a watch that I can time in 2 minutes. So on your mark, get set, go. Hi, I'm gonna count the number of times the right knee, keep going as fast as you can, comes up to the height of the skate. Keep going, higher. Okay, now keep going, but back up a little bit. Back up a little bit as you keep going. Good, higher. Good, as fast as you can for 2 minutes. This is a 2 minute drill. Good, high. And stop. Okay, now obviously the participant would keep going for 2 minutes. But you could see how she started to move forward, and that's why I have a longer piece of tape to allow for that. But I instructed her to move back, but also instructed her to keep moving, not to stop. And you'll run into that when you do this 2 minute step test. Again, that's the 2 minute step test to test aerobic endurance.